So I'm William Hardy, and I'm the sort of main director and the founder of Studio Hardy. We're quite difficult to explain. You know, it's quite difficult to explain exactly what we do, because we do so many different things. But essentially, I suppose we're problem solvers. We come from a vernacular craft background, but we approach new current problems. So that can be in a whole load of different fields. So architecture, furniture, children's playgrounds, big public art projects, exhibition builds, and then all sorts of random, unusual things. I grew up at a time where craft was still very much respected and woodwork was taught in schools. And we're now in an age, you know, the sort of digital, the CNC, the laser cutting, the 3D printing, which is very, very exciting technology, but potentially the death of craft and really, you know, knowing how to make things with your hands, knowing how to draw things with a pencil, knowing how to use a handsaw, etc. As the sort of traditional craft wanes, actually a resurgence comes out. People in a digital age suddenly, you know, even if it's just they want a wooden case for a mass-produced phone or a, you know, a piece of leatherwork, that sort of appreciation of tradition grows and grows. So this is this very subtle revolution, and I think with children especially, that, you know, they're dying to make. We get architects from very prestigious universities coming here just dying to make something. They're used to sitting at a computer, but they have no physical skills, and they really want to learn them. So I started off as going to art college, and then moved through into apprenticeships. I worked for various sculptors, various craftspeople, and sort of learnt parts of trades and a lot of material knowledge. But quite quickly got bored of that and didn't really see the point in endlessly making replica medieval buildings. So I wanted to push all of that old knowledge into the new with new forms. And my first big break was doing a big playground in the Middle East for the royal family of Jordan. And that sort of suddenly skyrocketed me into a really big challenge, you know, 42, 45 degrees heat, trying to take green oak out there. And so it really pushed the materials knowledge, but gradually forged a process and a kind of way of working, and gathered about me a team of experts of shipwrights, timber framers, joiners, cabinet makers. And beyond that sort of core team is a huge network. We're kind of a hub for all these different craftsmen that we build a team for each specific job. And our work is very much a hybrid of all these different trades and all these different traditions. I've got to admit, I love circular saws. I think because of the sort of timber framing background, you pretty much got it in your hand all day, and as you learn to work with very big timbers, you can't really be bothered to turn them around, so you learn how to use it on its side, drop cuts, and occasionally even upside down cuts. So that's a nice tool. I really admire Mariscal in Barcelona, a big practice. The reason I admire him is because I hope, like us, he has utterly smashed any boundaries between disciplines. He makes, he does comics, fine art, photography, architecture, animation, film, shower curtains, product design, and I genuinely think there's no better or worst in that. The shower curtain is up there with the fine art. I really love that. Always wanted to build a bridge. I think that wonderful language of support and the fact that you've got to create a very long thing that's got to take a lot of weight over a big span, and then how you can refine that to be as minimal as possible, and how that is an utter marriage of design, engineering, architecture, materials and make. So a bridge, a boat, I mean, it's one thing to make something that can stay still on land, but the idea that you make something that floats is pretty incredible. Boats have often led me into submarines. There are a couple of wooden submarines, and the first submarines were made in wood. I think the first one was made in Barcelona. And that is a pretty wacky challenge, but yeah, there's something that attracts me about that. So for 10 years, we've been working as William Hardy Design, and we felt after about 10 years, it was time for a change. And so we're starting a new venture, sort of reforming and growing up and becoming Studio Hardy. Now the reason for the name is it's a recognition that it's not just me, it's actually a team of different people with different expertise, and we're very, very democratic. We work together. The sort of philosophy here is that there shouldn't be a door between the studio and the workshop, but it's also a sort of exciting way of, I think, essentially growing up, reinventing ourselves, taking stock after 10 years, saying, wow, we've been on a roller coaster, experimental journey. Within that, we've tried lots of different things, lots of different systems, been very, very experimental, both in our work, but also how we work as a team. And I think it's the sort of consolidation of all that experimentation into Studio Hardy and a kind of a new start.